guys are always knocking. Pushed it through.
Not only that, think about your snapper, your holder. A lot of nerves for them, too.
You're crack of dawn, Monday morning coffee, strong pouring everything you got into a paycheck Friday night. Your power stroke, diesel, backhoe riding king, 18-wheeler driving, living life in between the lines of clocking in and quitting time. But then the six-string circus comes to town, we hang them speakers over the crowd. When the lights come on, everybody's screaming, lighters in the sky, and everybody's singing every word to every song of the girl that's singing.
I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. Anticipation is mounting for today's game. We've got two quarterbacks looking to make an impact. It's Wilson Seahawks going up against Palmer's Cardinals. And with that, it's off to the Valley of the Sun, Phoenix, Arizona, where we'll hand it over to our broadcasting team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to the Valley of the Sun and University of Phoenix Stadium here in Glendale. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Seattle Seahawks and the Arizona Cardinals. They come out here in the eye. First carry for Thomas Rawls. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. In on the stop, Kevin Minter. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line. Hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
He's going to let this one go deep. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third. Well, this past year, Arizona finished 7-8-1 here in the defensive starters for the Cardinals. What do you make of this football team defensively heading into next year, Charles?
Well, they're an aggressive group, and they didn't generate this.
Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. And the Cardinals, the big fella. And they bring this one back. A scoop and score. A fumble recovery touchdown for Arizona. So the defense forces the fumble. They get the score, and a guy on defense becoming offensive there, Charles.
And you know they love that. Any guy on defense loves to pick up the ball and have it in his hands and try and score himself. In this case, that's exactly what happened.
They'll be singing in the shower postgame. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. Fielded about a yard deep. And he is going to be tackled at the one-yard line. What a mess that was. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work.
All right, partner, get that disapproving look off of your face. He did get it out to the one-yard line. Yeah, I know. Wasn't the best play in the world. He's hoping his offense can bail him out.
Now Wilson back into his end zone. And this is caught. It's Jimmy Graham. You know, Charles, for Graham, so much concern early in the season about whether he'd be ready to play this year, what would happen, recovering from the tendon. Not only was he ready, he played every game this season for Seattle.
And it wasn't just the injury concern with Jimmy Graham. It's how Seattle runs their offense. Remember, when he was in New Orleans, he could expect a ton of passes to come his way. But in Seattle, that number was going to be reduced, would he be able to maximize what they were going to throw in his direction? And he certainly did this year, 65 catches.
65 catches, just shy of 1,000 yards, 6 touchdowns, too. Second and 10 now, Wilson. And Graham's got it over the middle. And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line. A gain of 4 on the play, and it'll be third down.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think...
Looking for Baldwin, intercepted. Picked off by Tony Jefferson. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line.
Well, surprise, surprise, partner. No, we know it's not a surprise. When you try to complete a pass against this Cardinals defense, there's a reason that they are known as the no-fly zone.
After the interception, here's Palmer. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete. And this offense on your screen, one of the guys who knows how to win football games, Larry Fitzgerald.
Plenty of athleticism, but plays the game with incredible intelligence.
Here we go.
They'll run for the first time with Johnson. And he'll be dropped at the 23 after a pickup of about 4. The tackle was made by Michael Bennett. The Seahawks, here's their defensive lineup.
Cam Chancellor is one of the best safeties in the game, but with his linebacker size, that allows the team to use him wherever they want to make plays.
Palmer now. And he's got Gresham. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Jermaine Gresham, a 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Cardinals will extend their lead. It's up and good, 15-0 here in the first quarter. Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They'll come out in the pistol. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it's a second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
On second down, here's Wilson. They set up the screen to Rawls.
Whoosh.
A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Now a play fake here on first down. Backing up, eluding the pressure right. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sack. Quarterback gets hit.
Shift together here from the D-line. Rawls, the lone man in the backfield. Off the play fake to Rawls. Wilson. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Deion Buchanan in there to drop him, and sacks on first and second downs are going to lead to a third and long. Big sack on second down. Now the offense needs to convert here on third. And they're going to go soft on the corners. Third and long, it's Wilson. He's going to air one out. Looking for Lockett, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line. The Cardinals Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make...
Looking for his tight end, fouls, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro free safety, Earl Thomas. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. And a great spot to start this drive from here. Palmer gives to Johnson, and he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. A gain of three, second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make the play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
And he fires one that's intercepted. And now off to the races, down the right side. Picked off by Deshaun Shedd. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Now that was a beautiful play, a pick six. You punctuate something like that, partner?
What do you mean, with an exclamation mark?
Exclamation mark, a big word. What would you do with that?
Ampersand?
I like it.
And that one makes it 14-7. Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number two, as we'll see one following the score on the final play before break. Here's Hauschka now to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. Oh, nice move. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have a good field position not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too. First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
It's a five-receiver set, three to the left, two to the right. Now it's Palmer. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Palmer now to throw on third down. Dumping it off for Johnson. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
It appears they found something that's working, and they keep going back to it. I guess you can actually say he has the hot hands now, doesn't he?
Yeah, well, it's one thing to hit your guy out of the backfield once, hit him a couple times. Yeah, you're right. Maybe they're onto something.
And I think a lot of that is simply, if you get it to him in space, more times than not, he's going to get more yardage than you expect out of each play.
It'll go as a gain of 10 there, and that'll be good for an Arizona first down. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Here's Palmer. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field that's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came
let's
up
go,
with
let's
it.
Go.
Second and 10 now, and it's Palmer. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
Now Palmer, screenplay, Johnson. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. Well contained there defensively. The screen gets only a yard, and it's fourth.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
And look at this. Catanzaro misses it left. It's no good, and this score will stay right where it is. So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, sent this one off target.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. CD, wanted to get your thoughts just on the landscape of the offseason for each of these teams. Super Bowl in the rearview mirror, but so much going on. People look at the draft a lot, but there's a lot more that goes into the offseason for these front offices, is there not?
It certainly is, and even before we get to the draft, you start with the combine. You know, that's held in Indianapolis every year, and you have about 350.
And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. And the Cardinals offense here ready to take over. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team, because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. Let's face it, we've been there, we've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
It's the Pro Bowl cornerback, Richard Sherman, and he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. Game clock at 2:01. Time for one final play before the two-minute warning. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. After the interception, here's Wilson. And it's caught over the middle. Wilson, a minute 58 to go in this first half of play. More from the desert after this. On second down, Wilson. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth. There he goes, left side. And they will score. It's a pick six for the Cardinals touchdown. I don't know who all is to blame there, but I love seeing pick sixes.
Nothing like seeing someone pluck it out of the air and go the other way and see people try to change directions. Hard to do.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. That's fielded in the end zone. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. Well, throw on first down with Wilson. The grab made by Curse over the middle. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 12 yards on the pickup, and it's good enough for a Seattle first. And now they're in the hurry-up. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. And the grab made by Doug Baldwin. Baldwin coming off his first Pro Bowl appearance. He had career highs, Charles, in catches with 94, over 1,100 yards. That also a career high. Pretty good season for Doug Baldwin.
And I think the place that he really started to take off was midway through 2015. The connection between he and his quarterback, Russell Wilson, where they were playing more from the pocket, bigger plays downfield, and that just propelled him into 2016. That, and anything he perceives as a slight, he uses it to his advantage, and he just goes out and plays.
And now the clock will stop as he's able to get up and spike it here. Well, they brought in an extra defensive back here, so probably not expecting a run on third and three.
A good call.
Here's Wilson. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
Feeling like they're not quite in field goal range yet, they're going to go for it on fourth. Fourth down, here's Wilson. And he's got Lockett. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. So the offense has it first and 10. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up. That's a really fine play there, because anytime you see a comeback route, that means you cannot just stay in one spot and make a play on the ball. You've got to move your feet and move with the receiver, and that's exactly what he did.
Second and 10, it's Wilson again. They set up the screen to Rawls. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. And they're going to speed things up here. Wilson. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Deion Buchanan. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there.
And now this one's intercepted. A third interception for Palmer. Picked off by Deshaun Shedd. And Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. Final play of the half, it's Wilson. And his throw's going to be incomplete. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And now here's Ross. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Again, it's Johnson. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
And that's a good sign right there as we start the third quarter. Because in the first half, not much space to run the football. And as we go into the half, you often think to ourselves, all right, what's the adjustment? What do they have to do? You know what a lot of the adjustments are? No adjustments. You know the game plan, been working on it all week. Maybe a little tweak here or there, a little bit better blocking. and now you're establishing the running game. I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're not doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
He lost two there, and it's third down.
As a guy carrying the ball, your eyes are going to direct your feet, and you're hoping they carry you to the open spaces. But it's awfully difficult at times because you have so many things you have to look out for. Where's the line blocking? Where's the traffic coming from? Tough to find open spots.
Play clock winding down. They'll hand it off now. Johnson. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth. Here comes the Cardinals punter now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. Now a high kick, almost a pooch punt. Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half?
Because
that's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards? Or? Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Chandler Jones coming in from that outside linebacker spot. He gets him down for a loss of five. Wilson to give to Rawls. And nothing doing here as this time the run maybe gets him back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
They go play action with Wilson. And he took the contact as he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win, and the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
Now here's Ross. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the Cards will take over, first and 10. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They've got the lead, last time had to punt it though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. They begin the drive with Johnson. Stays on his feet. And some room to roam now. And he'll David Johnson on his way. Touchdown, Cardinals. David Johnson, 59 yards. And the Cardinals now adding on to their lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 yards with a new rule as he's taken down right at the 20-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
No, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. On second down, Wilson. It's caught on the left side by Baldwin. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
I don't care how many times you tell the story, it never loses its luster for me. Doug Baldwin, undrafted out of Stanford, and plays like a number one receiver should in the NFL. I don't care how you cover him. I don't care that his size isn't great. He's the one that typically comes up with the football.
Absolutely. His roots go all the way back to Gulf Breeze, Florida, where he's from, right? On the water near Pensacola, and then, of course, to Stanford, and boy, he's been good. Wilson snags it left side. That throw good for four. It's second down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Here's Wilson to throw. This is complete. It's Baldwin. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. Down Wilson, and the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. So the incomplete pass brings up second down.
Every now and then you have some volleyball training actually comes into play as a defender. When a ball's tipped in the air, nice play by the defense, got a hand on it, but when it's in the air, it's up for grabs. And too many times in this league, we've seen great plays happen for an offense as a result of a ball tipped in the air. So what you really want to do is be that guy who comes off the back line and spikes it, knocks it to the ground. Don't let him have that opportunity.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
One of the best routes, one of the favorite routes of any play caller. He just ran now. A nice little angle route. That's supposed to be a catch, and usually it is. The running back dropped.
Yeah, I mean, he's a running back, but he's got hands. He should have caught it. And a short gain down to about the 33. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense, and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock. You control the ball. And that way, you often control the game.
On third down, Wilson. And able to find Graham, complete. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And the Cardinals getting set to trot out there now. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. They'll run it now out of the gun. And a nice gain there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20. They'll get four on second down, but it leaves them with third and still nine to go. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Time for a break. Here comes the Cardinals punter now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth.
Get ready. Blue 95. Blue 95. Regular. Regular. Chief. Sally 19. Sally 19. Get ready. White 18.
The Cardinals will go for it. It's Palmer. And he's got Gresham. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. See if they stay on the ground for second down. And the D looking like they may blitz. And Palmer gives to Johnson. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a third and nine situation. And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break.